Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Lamentations. The Lord has destroyed without mercy all the dwellings of Jacob. In his wrath, he has broken down the stronghold of Father Judah. He has brought down the ground in his honor, the kingdom, and its rulers. The elders of Brother of Zion sit on the ground in silence. They have thrown dust on their heads and put on sackcloth. The elders of Jerusalem have bowed down their heads to the ground. My eyes are spent with beauty, my stomach churns, my body is poured out on the ground because of the destruction of my people, because infants and babes faint in the streets of the city. They cry to their mothers, where is the bread and wine? As they faint like a woman in the streets of the city, as their life is poured out on their mother's bosom. What can I say for you to what compare you, O daughter of Jerusalem? To what can I liken you that I may comfort you, O Virgin of God, Zion? For vast as the sea is your ruin, who can heal you? Your prophets have seen for you false and deceptive visions. They have not exposed your iniquity to restore your fortunes, but have seen oracles for you that are false and misleading. Cry aloud to the Lord, O wall of the earth, Zion. Let tears stream down like torrent day and night. Give yourself no rest, your eyes no respite. Arise, cry out in the night, at the beginning of the watches. Pour out your heart like water before the presence of the Lord. Lift your hands to him for the lives of your children. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, forget not the life of your poor ones.
Lord, forget not the life of your poor ones.
O God, why do you cast us off forever? Why does your anger smoke against the sheep of your pasture? Remember your congregation, which you acquired long ago, which you redeemed to be the tribe of your heritage. Remember not the life of your king to build. Response.
Lord, forget not the life of your poor ones.
Direct your steps to the spirit, to the perpetual ruins. The enemy has destroyed everything in the sanctuary. Your foes have roared within your holy place. They set up their anthems there. At the upper entrance, they have the wooden covers with axes. Response.
Lord, forget not the life of your poor ones.
And then with hatchets and hammers, they smashed all its hardware. They set perpetuity on fire. They desecrated the dwelling place of your name, bringing it to the ground. Response.
Lord, forget not the life of your poor ones.
Have regard for your covenant for the dark places of the land, and full of haunts of violence. Do not let thou tyrant be put to shame, let the poor enemy praise your name. Response.
Lord, forget not the life of your poor ones.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Christ for our sickness endured our suffering.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you.
When Jesus entered Capernaum, a centurion came to him, appealing to him and saying, Lord, my servant is lying at home paralyzed in terrible distress. And Jesus said to him, I will come and cure him. The centurion answered, Lord, I am not worthy to have you come under my roof, but only speak the word, and my servant will be healed. For I also am a man under authority, with soldiers under me. And I say to one, go, and he goes. And to another, come, and he comes. And to my slave, do this. And the slave does it. When Jesus heard him, he was amazed. And he said to those who followed him, truly I tell you, in no one in Israel have I found such faith. I tell you, many will come from east and west and will eat with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven, while the heirs of the kingdom will be thrown into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And to the centurion Jesus said, go, let it be done for you according to your faith. And the servant was healed that hour. When Jesus entered Peter's house, he saw his mother-in-law lying with a fever. He touched her hand, and the fever left her. And she got up and began to serve him. That evening they brought to Jesus many who were possessed with demons, and cast out spirits with the word, and cured all who were sick. This was to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet Isaiah. He took our infirmities and bore our diseases. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the first reading, it says that the Lord has destroyed the dwellings of Jacob. He's let them fall into ruin. And in the Gospel, we have this beautiful story of the centurion. And Jesus said, well, in no place in Israel have I seen such faith. And so we know that our security always has to come from our faith in God. That the miracles, everything in our lives will come through that faith, that trust in God. Our temptation will always be, and it's worse in our situation, is to trust in ourselves, to let us make these things happen. It's very important for us to have that daily thanksgiving to God, to realize where things come from. You know, even if we are doing well, events in our lives, and we can trust them. Some people will be receiving the scapular today, and it seems like, well, how could you receive so much blessing from such a simple thing as receiving a piece of cloth, and the priest sprinkling the holy water? Well, because God is just that good. God is just that good. And as we participate in thanksgiving and grace, we will see great and wondrous things happen in our lives. And as we trust ourselves, well, we'll only get what we ourselves can achieve. And this is what we're always looking for. We're always looking for something greater than what humanity can offer us. We're looking for what God can offer us. That's why we should really take time each day to be thankful that we can come and pray and receive this Holy Eucharist and hear His Holy Word and be with Him today. It's the greatest honor we have each day of our lives to experience the blessing of God, to experience the loving hand of God, and to renew our faith so we know where to put our trust in. My dear brothers and sisters, gathered as one to celebrate the good things we have received from our God, let us ask Him to prompt in us prayers that are worthy of His hearing. We pray for our Holy Father Francis, for Pope Emeritus Benedict, for our Bishop Joseph, for their health and intentions and constant growth in faith, hope, and charity. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the grace to trust in your radical promises that you made to us, Lord, that we may delight in all the ways you have. Desire to bless us, all the graces you have bestowed upon us, the beautiful life that you have given us, the challenges. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for a greater devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary, who may trust in the promises that God makes to us. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for all the civil unrest in the world right now. We may turn to the law of God. Restore our lives to the great peace that He is calling us to. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We offer this Mass for our Blessed Mother's intentions. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
If you have any prayers and intentions, you may offer them up now. Pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for all the holy souls in purgatory and ask them to join us in the sins and angels in heaven, especially Blessed Nikita Budka, Saint Cyril of Alexandria, our Blessed Mother, Saint Joseph, to pray for mortal patients to the priesthood, to the consecrated life of the holy matrimony, to preserve all those in their vocations and assist us. Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body. blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may manage to be called to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you for your Son in Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the energy of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Savior's command, from my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day.
body of